Hi everyone! Ever wondered why your LinkedIn account can get restricted or even banned? Stick around because we are breaking down the top reasons and explaining how to stay in the clear. Let's get started and make sure you're playing the LinkedIn game by the rules. LinkedIn takes their user guidelines seriously. Violate their policies and you risk warnings, suspension, or even a lifetime ban. Well, let's start with understanding the difference between LinkedIn ban types. First, warnings. They serve as initial alerts that your activities are straying from LinkedIn's policies. These are your first hints to adjust your behavior. Second, temporary restriction. In this case, your account can be hit by a short-term suspension, limiting access to it until some date. LinkedIn might also issue requests for verification if they suspect something's off or just as a regular procedure. You'll be asked to verify your identity to keep using your account. For a more subtle form of control, shadow bans might come into play. Your activity will be limited or hidden without any clear notification, meaning your posts or comments might not be visible to other users. In the most severe cases, permanent ban can be applied. This means your account is completely disabled and you lose access to all LinkedIn features. Now let's look at what can get you restricted. Probably you use Chrome extensions to simplify your routine tasks on LinkedIn. But here's the catch. LinkedIn is against these extensions and automation tools in general, and they have algorithms to detect them. They don't just monitor the usage of unauthorized extensions. They can even check the presence of them in your browser. Even having them installed can get you warnings. Browser extensions can never be 100% safe due to technical limitations. So what should you do? Well, use safe browser-based automation tools like Link Helper 2 that leave no traces on the LinkedIn page. Also, scan your browser for any malicious detectable extensions. How? Good news! We've compiled a list of bad LinkedIn extensions to keep your account safe. Ready to check it out? I'll show you how. First, open this article in our blog using the link in the description. Select Bonus Check if LinkedIn is detecting your Chrome extension section. Now, open this document. Make a copy of the document so that you can add the list of your extensions. Go back to the article, copy this link and paste it in the search bar of the browser. Expand the list of extensions here. Carefully select the list of IDs and names of these extensions and copy. Paste it into a notepad on your computer. Do not use Google Sheets, Word, or other text editors for this. This is required to ensure that when pasting into a spreadsheet, the list is broken into rows. Select this data again in your notepad and copy it. Open the copied spreadsheet. Click on the cell Your Chrome Extension IDs and paste the copied extensions. Now go to Data, then Split Text to Columns. And here they are, highlighted in red, extensions that LinkedIn is attempting to detect and that are installed in your Chrome browser. I have a couple of them, so let's delete them from the browser. If you have a virtual assistant or an agency managing your LinkedIn account, you've probably created parallel activity from simultaneous usage. You might think, so what? Why is this bad? Well, Here's the deal. LinkedIn explicitly states in their user agreement that sharing your account is a big no-go. They track IP addresses and session data so they know when many people are managing the same account at the same time. Logging in from multiple locations or using too many IPs can also be a red flag for LinkedIn. Again, this scenario is possible if you hand over access to your account to an assistant or to a lead generation expert and they are located in a different country than you are. Of course, there won't be any consequences if you travel a lot and access your account from different countries during business trips from time to time. But if you access your account in the morning from, let's say, Germany, and then at noon from the United States, this will look suspicious and can trigger a restriction. So what's the solution? The best thing to do is to agree on a common schedule for using your LinkedIn account to avoid overlapping activity. Also, make sure that your assistant logs into your account from the same location as you do. They can use proxy or VPN to match your location. And if you're using Link Helper, we've got you covered. Our tool allows you to set up working hours and assign a unique proxy for each account that you manage. Getting reported for spam or inappropriate content can lead to a ban, so here are some quick tips to keep in mind. First, avoid sending repetitive, unsolicited messages or posting irrelevant to promotional content. No one likes spam. Being overly salesy or sending messages packed with links also increase your chances of being reported and getting too many "I don't know this person" responses to your invitations. Also, steer clear of controversial topics. LinkedIn is a professional platform, so it's best to avoid sensitive subjects that can alienate your audience. Always remember to be nice, maintain your professional integrity, and you'll keep your account in good standing. Misrepresenting your identity or creating an account for someone else is another big LinkedIn no. If your account is for a real person, like yourself, you've got nothing to worry about. Just be prepared to verify your identity when LinkedIn asks you to. Engaging into certain manual activities that deviate from natural user behavior can also lead to warnings. It's a common fallacy among many LinkedIn users that if they work manually on LinkedIn, they will never get banned. Want proof? Try going through every page of the search results, adding people by clicking the connect button every 5 seconds or so. LinkedIn will kick you out of the platform. Log back in and repeat this 3 or 4 times and you'll get restricted. Or send 100-200 connection requests in one day and you'll soon find out that LinkedIn either demands you to enter a valid email address for every person you're trying to connect with, or worse, restricts your profile. I recorded this piece to demonstrate bad user behavior, and guess what happened today? When I tried to log into my LinkedIn account, I was prompted to complete a quick security check. After passing it, I faced a restriction requiring verification. Well, the process is pretty easy and needs to be done on a mobile phone. First, I scanned a QR code, selected the country that issued my ID, and uploaded a photo of it. LinkedIn then sent me an email confirming that they're reviewing my request. LinkedIn monitors unhuman-like behavior closely. Sudden changes in behavior or performing too many actions in a short period of time can lead to temporary restrictions. Having too many pending requests can also raise red flags. To avoid this pitfall, stick to safe limits. Even if you work manually or use the safest automation tool, we recommend 150 actions per day. Cancel unaccepted invitation requests every 3 weeks and keep an eye on your acceptance rate. Avoid single type actions like visiting all your first degree connections just to get their emails. Instead, differentiate your activity. In Linked Helper, this is easy thanks to the advanced limits. And of course, don't ignore warnings. If LinkedIn says your activity looks suspicious and you might be using automation tools, stop high monotonous activity immediately. It's not just a number of actions that can trigger a warning from LinkedIn, but also how you do them. What does this mean? Let me explain to you. There are two ways to open a profiles page on LinkedIn. The first way is to type the name of the person you're looking for on LinkedIn and select the right contact from the options that appear. The second way is to paste the profile's link into the browser address bar and hit enter. Both methods get you to a profile, but they show different behaviors to LinkedIn. The latter, automation tool-like behavior. Clearly, you won't be blocked after opening just a couple of profiles via URLs, but try doing this with 50 profiles and most likely you will be logged out of your account. Keep this up and you'll see a warning message from LinkedIn suspecting you of using an automation tool. The same thing happens when you right-click on a profile name and choose Open Link in New tab or Open Link in New window. Avoid opening profiles via URLs using any method described. Use LinkedIn search instead. And in Link Helper 2, we use in-page navigation. It searches profiles via LinkedIn search using their names, just like an average user would do. Let's summarize. Avoid malicious extensions. LinkedIn detects them. Just having them installed can get you banned. Stick to safe tools like Link Helper 2. Be careful with simultaneous usage. LinkedIn tracks IPs and sessions, so coordinate with your virtual assistant and use proxy or VPN to match locations. Don't spam. Sending too many unsolicited messages or posting controversial topics is a quick way to get reported. Stay professional and trustworthy. Stay real and don't create fake accounts. Always be ready to verify your identity. Watch your activity levels. 200 connection requests a day can get you restricted. Keep your activity varied and natural. Skip URL navigation. LinkedIn flags this. Use in-page search to look up profiles. In addition, stay active on LinkedIn. Post or at least repost something from time to time. Fill out the information about yourself and use a professional-looking photo. When a profile is almost blank, it might seem suspicious as well, especially for those who you're connecting with. Here is a final tip for automation tools users. Even if you are keeping your activity levels low, a poorly designed automation tool can still get you in trouble with LinkedIn. That's why Link Helper is your go-to choice for smooth, risk-free automation. Stay safe and make the most out of your LinkedIn experience. Thank you for watching and see you next time.